Hi Waffles! I will explain in English in this video. 한국 분들은 한국어 자막을 켜주세요. 니혼고노 지마쿠모 준비 사례로 요때이 됐어요. Today I wear a suit, which is very rare because I really hate wearing a suit. But in the book, The Little Prince, Antoine de Saint-Exupéry said, When you give a presentation, if you wear a suit, people will listen to you. People will listen to what you're saying. Otherwise, they don't. That's the reason why I wear a suit today, because I want you to listen to what I'm saying. If you are interested in doing something on YouTube, as working as a YouTuber or uploading YouTube content, this video will be incredibly helpful for you. I'm absolutely the largest number one wine YouTuber on this planet Earth for now. My channel is 4 times bigger than the largest US wine channel. If it is not, please leave a comment. I would appreciate it. I'm from South Korea and my mother tongue is Korean, not English. So the situation was not favorable. But my channel recently showed 20,000% of a growth rate on views for only 1 week. And my channel is still growing very fast. I show you a graph here. It happened middle of August. The growth rate on views has increased in 21,881%. Meaning, if you had invested 100 bucks in my business, I would get back to you with more than $2 million. 20,000% is that kind of number. So this is an incredible success. I will show you how I could make this kind of big success. Talking about 3 things. Successful factors, strategies, examples from somebody else's, other YouTubers' channels. Number 1. Being a YouTuber shouldn't be your ultimate purpose. It should be a marketing tool. So YouTubing shouldn't become your job. 유튜브 자체가 생계수단이 돼서는 안 돼요. 목적이 돼서는 안 돼요. Before becoming a YouTuber, you should become a little expert in a certain field. Better than the average people, even a little bit. That is very important because people watching your content would appreciate that factor. I'm a professional in wine. Having 3 different master's degrees from 3 different countries, France, Spain, Italy. And I'm a polyglot. I'm very good at learning foreign languages, speaking 8 different languages, and I'm pretty good at communicating with other people. So I combined all these factors, and I think this YouTube channel as a marketing tool to advertise myself and the people around me, because I know so many good people around me. But if you have ever thought that YouTube can be your purpose, making money from a YouTube channel, I show my bank account related to my channel. And I show you for the last 4 years how much money I made. I began my YouTube channel February 2017, 3.5 years ago. But before this channel, I already had another channel. So in total, it's been exactly 4 years. And for the last 4 years, I made $3,804.41. If I had begged on the street, I would have made much more money than this. So as a job, this is a terrible job, you know, the worst job in the world. But if you are professional in something as a marketing tool, this is fantastic because you don't pay money for advertising yourself. On the contrary, eventually you can make money from the channel, right? So you have to think about that kind of balancing, right? Number 2, sleep on the idea if you have to work as a YouTuber. But once you decided to be involved in this, don't stop until you upload 100 content. 유튜브를 시작할지 신중하게 생각을 하세요. 하지만 일단 시작하면은 영상 100개는 만들어 올려야 된다고 각오를 하셔야 돼요. This YouTube channel works like an amusement park. If somebody enters an amusement park, they begin to use lots of facilities. And if the quality of the facilities is extremely good, then they stay there. They enjoy themselves and they come back. If your content is not good, then people once visit your channel and they leave and they never come back. So think like you have only one good chance. Number three, content doesn't matter. What matters is contents in content. 콘텐츠를 만드는 게 중요한 것이 아니라 콘텐츠의 내용이 중요한 거예요. This is the most important thing. Each content should contain unique purpose in it. If you can contain multiple messages in one content, then that's the best. For example, in my channel, I try to include knowledge about wine, information about language learning, and joie de vivre in food, wine, and travel, speaking with people. So I try to have multiple positive messages in my content, and people appreciate it. That's very important. And number four, don't keep producing content in the same style because you got used to it. 맨날 똑같은 콘텐츠만 만들지 마세요. 변해야 합니다. There is a very good example. I'm really sorry to talk about this channel, but this is such a good example. There is a channel named Wine of the Month Club, and it has 1,661 videos. This is a great number. I believe I have a little bit more than 100 videos, and this guy has 15 times more than what I have. But the number of subscribers is only 585 compared to my number, over 170,000 subscribers. The reason why this guy fails in getting more subscribers is just because even though his video is not effective, he doesn't want to change. He's keeping his own style. I should change. I should evolve myself. I should be more creative, trying to change myself. When I get back to my first video in a few years later, then I'll talk to myself that, oh, this is terrible. My first video was really terrible. Meaning, I've evolved myself tremendously. Today's video is a proof of evolving myself. This video is my very first video talking about YouTube channel's growth strategy. And I strongly believe this video will work well and will get a certain amount of number of subscribers in a year or two. Oh, the people around you will try to discourage you, saying your content is not fun, it's useless, it's meaningless, that kind of thing. People will say so, but don't get discouraged because you are the person who are doing this one and you should have your own confidence. At least if you are little professional in your field, then believe yourself and do this and accumulate at least 100 content in your channel. Number five, don't imitate somebody else's content. Be honest. The viewers feel it. Viewers know it. 남들이 이미 한 콘텐츠를 보고 따라하지 마세요. 솔직하세요. 구독자분들이 아세요. The viewers are much more sensitive than you may think. On YouTube, there are full of original content. They are very unique. And it is like, for example, here is a Louis Vuitton bag. And here is another one, which is a fake one. Both of them are free of charge. Then which one would you take? This real Louis Vuitton bag, I believe. It happens on YouTube channel. Everything is free. This real original content is free. And this fake one is free too. Of course, people prefer this original one to the fake one. And then the viewers sense it on your channel, and then they leave your channel. So you should be very honest. Please don't try to deceive your viewers or subscribers, okay? Number six, make your content fun and communicate with your subscribers. 재미있게 콘텐츠를 만드세요. 그리고 구독자분들과 소통을 하세요. People never keep watching boring content because on YouTube there are so many informative and educative and at the same time so much interesting content. So If your content is boring, then there is no reason why they have to stay in your channel. The viewers are very judgmental. Try to make it fun. For example, I'm not a fun guy, and I know it. And my friends often tell me that I'm not fun at all. I know it. But when I communicate with people, my friends, then I make a lot of fun with them. So I'm using that factor to make my content much more fun. And it works. People love it. So try to be creative to make big fun. Number 7. Put yourself in somebody else's shoes. Watch your content from somebody else's point of view. 다른 사람의 시각으로 여러분의 컨텐츠를 보는 연습을 부단히 하세요. 다른 사람의 시각으로 여러분의 컨텐츠를 보는 연습을 계속해서 하셔야 돼요. You are not the person who judge the quality of your content. Your viewers, your subscribers evaluate the quality of your content. So you have to think about their opinions from their point of view. Otherwise, you are thinking you are making great content, but nobody watches it because it's shit. Number 8. Upload your content in regular term, like once a week or twice a week, on a specific date of week. As often as possible, but the frequency shouldn't harm the quality. 영상을 규칙적으로 올리세요. 가능하면 자주 올리시는데요. 하지만 빈도가 영상의 질을 해쳐서는 안 됩니다. If you upload your content regularly, then your subscribers wait for your content on that date. In my case, I do everything on my own. I plan my content, I prepare for it, then I shoot the footage, then I edit it, I photograph it, then I subtitle on it, then I create a title and explanation about it, and I do everything on my own, by myself. So 2 years ago, I could only create a content once every 2 weeks. But as time goes by, I got used to it, and now I can create 2 content a week, doing something else at the same time, doing my own work. So try to do it regularly, okay? Number 9, consume other YouTubers' content and learn from them. And make it as your asset. And that helps you be creative. 다른 분들의 컨텐츠를 많이 보세요. 그게 여러분들께 또 도움이 됩니다. Otherwise, you get stuck in your little pool. In your little trivial idea. You should make your pool much bigger. And for that reason, you have to learn something new from other people. In my case, I have 3 main teachers. The first teacher, it's a Korean channel named 주부 아빠. He is very good at analyzing the YouTube algorithm, especially for the beginners. For smaller YouTubers, he's very helpful. So if you are Korean and at the initial stage of YouTubing, then visit his channel and learn. The second channel is an American channel named Think Media. This channel is very good when you don't know about which camera you should buy, or which tripod is good in this price range, or which lights are the best for a limited budget. This channel is very helpful to get to know about these tools to make YouTube. And what is very good about this channel is I'm a foreigner, and I began to get really interested in learning English after I became an adult. And this guy, when he says in his video, his articulation is outstanding. His English pronunciation is so evident, and his intonation is great. He moves his mouth like this. So, I learn English from his channel. It's incredibly good that you can have good information from a channel and you learn a language, foreign language, from this channel at the same time. This is the best. And this is my channel's role too. You learn about wine, you learn about languages, and you feel the love between people around me. And you will enjoy the joie de vivre. And the third channel that I love is Bunkorube. It's a Japanese channel. And it's about a tamed bird. It only has 30,000 subscribers now. But whenever I get stressed, I visit this channel and I see her videos and I feel myself in peace. Please don't laugh at me because being in a good condition is extremely important to make good content. You should feel good. And then your viewers can feel it. Then they subscribe to your channel. Otherwise, you make a shit. And people leave your channel. Number 10. Don't be afraid of challenging new things. As a very easy example, look at Peter and Patrick. They are not young anymore, but they always try to do something new with me. They challenge new things. They never step back from a new challenge. And that factor gives a breath or energy into my content because we challenge all together. So I showed 10 important tips to be successful as a YouTuber or 10 different reasons why you should give up to be a YouTuber. So sleep on it for some time, please, and then make a final decision, your own decision. You know, recently, because of this special situation, everybody sits at home and they shoot videos. They upload their videos on YouTube. So everybody is doing this. It's a very, very, probably the most competitive market in this world now. So be informed, be prepared, and be successful. Then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and leave a like. And please visit my Instagram. See you next time. Thanks, Waffles.
이럴 땐 이와인 네이버밴드로 놀러 오시면 와인을 잘 몰라도 편하고 싸게 사실 수 있도록 제가 많이 도와드립니다. 다들 만족하시고 좋아하시더라고요.